You also, if I may get autobiographical for a second, for you, have, as I recall, have a lot of experience with the downtown so-called alternative club scene, and I mean, for many years, right? I assume, and drag scene and so forth, I assume that that exposure and that participation has influenced your working imagination, yes?
Absolutely. I mean, absolutely. As I said, when I was 10 years old, I wanted to own a bar.
And
it all started in Chicago in the early 80s. I was working at a very well-known club called Metro, where every cool band came through town, was played at Metro. And there was also this bar called Smart Bar, which was, the name of that was based on a line from Naked Lunch, actually. And that was just, you know, a wild sort of very small bar that all the freaks in Chicago went to. And back in the 80s, I was just talking to the woman in the Huffington Post about that. Back in, you know, starting in the late 70s, I mean, I was totally underage back then, but I would sneak out and have fake IDs and go to these clubs. The club world was really inclusive, you know, gay, straight, whatever. You know, it was just very inclusive. Of course, there were these great gay bars where it was just like funka thunka house music all night long and poppers and stuff like that, which was really wild, too, and I would go to those. I'm blanking on some of those names. Well, of course,
sure.
You know, everything's a little bit of a fog, as they say. And then...
when did you
in New York? There was
New York?
Well, I always, I mean, I really, I'm kind of new to New York in the sense that I really didn't move here full time till 1998, 99. But I had been starting to come to New York since, I mean, on a regular basis, probably since 1985. I would come here at least once a year. Ever since 1985. And at that point in time, I, you know, through mutual friends from Chicago, I met people like Kemba Fowler, who is the voluptuous whore of Karen Black, Carla McCormick, who writes for Paper Magazine and used to be the doorman at this bar, Max Fish. The Click Club was a club I used to go to. Oh, but way before that, it was, of course, the Mug Club, Danceteria, AMPM, these after-night bars. Yeah, all those places. Yeah, all of those places back then.
Well, I'd like to come back to that.
Yeah, and then so, you know, clubs were my life, and there were a lot of great musicians I met at that time who I was still close with. And,